Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good afternoon. Welcome to the Gold Dome here on the campus of Seminary College for Championship Sunday of the 2024 Southern Collegiate Athletic Conference Men's and Women's Basketball Championship. Our first contest of the day is the Men's Championship game, featuring the number 4 seed, the Colorado College Tigers, against the number 3 seed, the Seminary Gents. For this afternoon's game, on the special singing of our national anthem performed by a member of the Seminary College Choir, Nina Guerrero.
It all comes down to this. Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen, to the Gold Dome here in Shreveport, Louisiana. We're back at Centenary College for Championship Sunday. Had a couple of upsets in the bracket yesterday, so we'll have a matchup between the 4-seeded Colorado College Tigers and the host school, number 3-seeded Centenary College Gents. Just had Colorado College starters announced. Take you through those quickly. As the Gents get ready to come out themselves, for the Tigers, it'll be Nofziger, Boykin, Rueg, Filio, and Ty Hindler rounding out the five. The third different starting lineup in 3 days for head coach Jeff Conroe, but things the exact same on the other side for coach Chris Dorsey and the Centenary Gents. It's going to be Collier, Thomas, Quentin Beverly, Jalen Bear, and rounding out the five, Jacoby Greenlee. If you haven't joined us the last 2 days, we'll recap how each of these teams got here. As mentioned, both these squads playing their third game today. They had to come from the quarterfinals. Colorado did so by beating the University of Dallas on day one, 87-58, and then they upset the top-seeded Trinity Tigers yesterday, 71-70. Centenary winning a couple of days ago against the Shriner Mountaineers, also a one-point margin, 76-75, but a more comfortable win over the St. Thomas Celts yesterday, 64-51. Colorado was Boykin, who helped them through in edging out Trinity. 20 points, 12 rebounds, a solid double-double. The other way, it's been a mixed bag for the Gents. Seth Thomas had 20 against Shriner, but yesterday it was A.J. Hall off the bench who led the way with 16. as the crowd here in the Gold Dome gets ready for the tip. They're up on their feet. It has been a rocking atmosphere here in Shreveport for all of these Gents games. Expect much of the same here today as Greenleaf and Filio are set to tip and the Gents control it. Collier, who goes back to retrieve it, and he brings it across the timeline. Checked there by Hindler. He'll give off to Beverly up top to Thomas, who barely holds on to it. Boykin went for the steal. Kick to the corner. Bear thought about it briefly, but he'll drive to the middle. Greenleaf has it again, barreling inside, and he'll finish for the first two of the game. Gents get the scoring started early, and they'll keep up the pressure. Past few days has seen this Gents defense move into a 1-3-1 zone where they'll start. It's provided some issues for the opposition as Hindler will pick up his dribble. Rueg going to the corner. Boykin downloaded Nofziger. Cross-court pass, Rueg trying to get to the middle, but he's cut off. Nofziger again in the corner. He rises up, but his three ball well short. Filio catches the air ball, but he's rejected by Thomas. Ball's loose, but Bear will pick it up and bring it back quickly for the Gents. They'll give it back out against a Colorado team that has provided very good perimeter defense in their two games so far. But Bear will get straight to the cup and finish. Two nice plays to get to the rim for the Centenary Gents, and it has them out ahead in this one, 4-0. Rueg will catch and settle in the front court. As this 1-3-1 extends far beyond that three-point line, but Hindler with a little bit of a gap gives to Filio, who lets the defender slide by, but he leaves the layup short. He had the opportunity, but just missed the bunny, and Seth Thomas will bring it the other way. Trying to use a couple of screens, gets up in the air and finds Bear to bail him out. Opposite corner now, Collier using the screen from Greenleaf, getting downhill, and he'll try, but instead will throw it over the top of the backboard. That one ends up out of bounds. So Colorado College getting a stop there. But a quick minute 45 gone, and the Tigers looking for their first bucket. Hindler and Rueg trying to get it across the timeline. It'll be Hindler who does so. Still with 20 seconds remaining on the shot clock, down to Nofziger. They have Boykin at the free throw line, but Nofziger will go himself. A little bit of contact there. He lost his balance, and he dragged that pivot foot. So a travel against Colorado College. Stout defense continues from Centenary, who have played back-to-back games, their third consecutive day. Tired legs for each of these squads, but Centenary with the boost of playing at home. Greenleaf getting downhill. Filio cutting him off again, but he's trying to navigate. Throws that up a little bit short. Hindler will control the other way for the Tigers, trying to find a backdoor cutter, but he loses his dribble. Rueg has to come and get it, and he'll hand off to Boykin. Boykin dribbles into the pressure. Rueg from straight away, and he catches it from way downtown. Scott Rueg breaks the seal for Colorado, and they trail by one. It's Beverly going one-on-one, challenging Rueg. Spins, fades, puts that up and in. Silky finish from Quinton Beverly. Colorado still facing this pressure. Hindler and Rueg haven't had much of an issue with it so far, taking their time, and they have a couple of ticks still remaining when they get it across the timeline. Inside to Nofziger. He sees Hindler just inside the free throw line. That one rolls off. Nofziger had a hand on it, but instead he tips it to Jalen Bear, who will bring it across for the Gents. This one off to Beverly. Up top, well outside the three-point line to Greenleaf. He'll give to Thomas, who will pull it quickly, and he knocks it home. He goes to the ground, but it didn't matter. Seth Thomas cashing in from beyond the arc. The hot start continues for Centenary. Up the court quickly. Boykin forcing the issue. He misses it. Nofziger gathers the offensive rebound off his own tipped miss. He gets that one up and in. Fighting through traffic. Nofziger will finish with the foul. Asher Nofziger started game one of these SCAC championship games. He had a very good outing. 12 points, 10 rebounds. A little quieter yesterday in his role off the bench, but a good start here as he finishes the three-point play. Still over 16 remaining in this opening half. Seth Thomas loses his dribble, gives over to Greenleaf. That ball's loose. Dittman goes to the ground. He comes away with it, able to get it to Rueg, ahead to Boykin. Challenge at the rim. Thomas can't get a piece of it, though. Denari Boykin cuts this lead back to one. It's Gavin Carter into the game for the Tigers, checking on the perimeter. Kevin Dittman also on, wearing number 45 with those black jerseys. Corner. Sees Jalen Bear go baseline. He hangs in the air and he finishes. Nofziger right there, but it didn't matter. A tough make. Gavin Carter will assume the responsibilities that Ty Himmler had just moments ago. He and Rueg bringing it across the timeline. Rueg thought about stepping into that deep three. Now 15 on the shot clock. Gets Seth Thomas off his feet. Nofziger in the short corner. He swarmed there, tries to get it away, but it's deflected. Greenleaf comes away with it, and then he gets fouled. Looked like Denari Boykin, who is trying to get the ball back for Colorado College. That is the case. He hit Greenleaf in the face. Now under 16 minutes in this opening half. That stoppage of play will give us our first break, media timeout number one. A very energetic start for Centenary. 5 of 7 from the field. Seth Thomas knocking down that big three-point shot from the wing. But Colorado College withstanding this first burst out of the gate. Trailed by just 3 of 8 from the field. Scott Rueg knocking down a three ball himself, and Nofziger, a nice three-point play on the inside, has them within one possession in the early going. It's a Colorado College team that has great size between Nofziger, Crawford, Filio, and Price. They've used all four of their bigs and relied on them heavily this weekend. Big presence on the inside, but Centenary and their two games in this 1-3-1 zone have been very stout. Yesterday against St. Thomas, frustrating the Celts and holding them to a very low 51 points. Both teams break their huddles, are back out onto the court. Collier will give back to Seth Thomas. They'll get it right back. Checked by Gavin Carter on the outside as Colorado currently in a man look. Greenleaf against Price, who just checked into the game. He'll burst by him, get to the rim, and he finishes there. Nice move, putting it back in his right hand to get it up off the glass. Price spots Boykin at half court, trying to go quickly in transition. He loses the ball briefly and then blocked by Quinton Beverly. But he blocked it all the way out of bounds into the student section on the near side. So the Tigers keeping a hold of the basketball, just a tick under 20 seconds on the shot clock. Plenty of time on this possession as Gavin Carter will ask for a screen on the outside from Price. Rueg again from straightaway. Again, he makes it. Scott Rueg, back-to-back threes to start his day. Huge in the win against Trinity yesterday. He was 3 for 6 from downtown. Did a really nice job of pressuring the Tigers, their counterpart, Jacob Harvey. But Seth Thomas not fazed at all by the big make from Rueg. He rises up from the mid-range himself and knocks another one home. Carter advances to Boykin on the wing, but he won't go. Up top, Rueg deep. Thought about it maybe briefly, but thought better of it. Carter picks up his dribble and finally will shoot this one. He knocks it home as well. Lost the dribble, but he found himself undefended right at the three-point line, and he made it count. Just a one-point game again. Seth Thomas brings it up, gives off to Beverly. Cross to Greenleaf. Doesn't hand to Beverly, and he'll go one-on-one, pulling up from the mid-range this time, and it rims off. Just a little bit short. Shot that one over the top of Adrian Price. Carter bringing it across, will hand to Rueg. In close quarters, gives back to Carter. Spots Price on the block, just a sliver of space there. A nice cross-court pass from Gavin Carter to fit it inside to his big man, who goes straight into the teeth of the defense and draws the foul. With that, Adrian Price will step to the free throw line. He'll shoot his first two attempts of the day. Struggled a bit at the line yesterday, just 1 of 4 as the first is up and falls off. Put it on the rim and gave it a chance, but it would not fall through the cylinder. It was a Colorado team that overall in yesterday's semifinal affair struggled at the line, just 9 of 19, finishing under 50% from the mark. Price trying to get to 50%, that one up and good, he does so. And he knots this ball game up at 15. Singleton and Board come on for the Gents and Coach Dorsey. Board will handle it out top, going one-on-one against Price. Singleton maybe open for a sliver right there as he tried to make the backdoor cut. Instead goes to Board, nice up and under move, but he can't finish at the rim. Nice challenge there by the Tigers as they come back quickly in transition. Corner Romero into the game now for Coach Conroe. That one tipped as it was trying to be fed back to Romero. So it'll head out of bounds and stay with Colorado. Rueg will give to Gavin Carter, playing right at half court on that inbound. That one tipped again, but winds up with Dittman in the corner. He tries to throw it the opposite corner, but throws it instead off the back corner of the backboard. So a turnover for Colorado right there. So they had the opportunity to take the lead. Instead, the pressure of the Centenary zone getting to them. And the Gents will come back the other way. Thomas creating some separation, trying to go right off of it as Quentin Beverly will receive the pass. He'll shoot that one from the mid-range. A ton of contact right there as he was elevating for the shot. Looked like Romero, who was in defense, caught the legs as Beverly was trying to fade away. Beverly stepping to the free throw line for the Gents' first two attempts of the day. Knocks the first one down after a perfect day yesterday, 4 for 4 at the charity stripe. Those 4 points yesterday, part of his 12-point total. Good for second on the team. Is this one also falling through? Rueg will take it out. Board applying some pressure on the inbounder. That one skied to Trey Crawford, fresh into the game for Colorado. 6'9" senior, a ton of size and length on the inside as Romero catches in the far corner, but he misses it long. Crawford going to the ground hard as he tried to sky for the rebound. Some contact and he'll stay on the ground. Gents playing 5-on-4 and they take advantage of it. Singleton to the rim. He finishes through the contact. And one opportunity. Tykeem Singleton in off the bench. Crawford on the other end of the court, who still is down. Helped to his feet by some staff in the gym, and he'll limp off. He skied trying to snatch an offensive rebound. Looked like there was some contact, and as he twisted and fell to the ground, he landed pretty hard on his backside. Gents were able to take advantage of it, and Singleton furthers that advantage. Back out to a 5-point lead as he finishes the 3-point play. Board providing some pressure in the backcourt. He'll play at the top of this 1-3-1 zone as Romero catches, and that one is good. High arcing shot from Edgar Romero. Missed his first, but made up for it right there. Cuts the lead back to 2. Great start from the outside for Colorado College. As Singleton has it against Rueg on the far wing, he'll pull it back. but now tries to back down number 10. This one stripped away. It's Gavin Price who had hands on it for just a minute. That one up for Seth Thomas, left it just a little bit short. That one careening all the way out of bounds as Thomas missed it off the near side of the rim. But lands out of bounds with 11:31 to play here in the first half. Another media timeout. As the guard play defensively for Colorado College has been very good the last several days. It was Gavin Carter on that last possession who came over and was able to strip the basketball away. Retained with the gents, but a little bit of a scramble drill offensively to get a shot up there. Guard play very heavy for both of these squads. Seth Thomas provides some great length for Centenary. Veteran in the SCAC. He's been great in his career here in Shreveport. Alongside him, Craig Collier, Quentin Beverly have been great in two games so far. Looked like there was a new gent that just walked to the scorer's table. We'll have a change as we come out of our second media timeout. Both teams headed back onto the court at the moment. It'll be Board Mirage in for Centenary with Singleton, Beverly, and Thomas. The other way, it's Rueg, Carter, Romero, Boykin back onto the court, and Filio, who replaced Crawford after he went to the ground hard. Colorado has it after the miss from Seth Thomas. Tough spot to get the ball inbounded. Rueg does get it to Boykin, and they'll get it across the timeline with plenty of time to spare. Romero catches it, gets it inside now to Filio. An opposite block. Boykin had positioning, but a great last-second opportunity defensively. Saw a tipped ball, and that tip deflection creates the turnover, the ball going back to Centenary right here as it was tracked down by Rueg trying to pitch it over to Carter, but Colorado getting tagged with the backcourt violation. Mirage catches for his first offensive possession, handoff to Beverly, kick back across to Mirage, operating outside, and he'll give to Board at the top of the key, standing right on the three-point line. Seth Thomas comes to get it, but guarded heavily by Denari Boykin with just two on the shot clock, has to hoist it, doesn't draw iron, but Rueg had the ball in his control before the buzzer sound. Boykin back the other way, Rueg over to Carter, still being pressured far outside the three-point arc, but they find Boykin at the free throw line, forcing the issue. He tosses it to the rim as Centenary was trying to collapse. Colorado just trying to find some space within this 1-3-1 zone that the gents have on right now. That time, ball being slipped inside to Denari Boykin, quickly operating, recognized the defenders closing, took advantage of the contact. He knocks down his first free throw. Boykin on the year, about a 75% free throw shooter. Yesterday, in their win against Trinity, he struggled a little bit at the line, just 6 of 11. But he made some big ones down the stretch as they held on. Second one is on its way, and it's also good. So that draws the Tigers even as A.J. Hall checking into the game for Coach Dorsey. His first minutes here in the first half. Mentioned he was a catalyst yesterday. Singleton goes to the hole. Somehow, as he lost his balance, had his legs taken out from under him, put it off the square and through. Great finish from Singleton right there. Mirage in the backcourt, checking Carter. Bringing across, gives up top to Rueg. Into the corner, Boykin trapped there, but he splits it and loses the ball in the process. A little bit too much traffic for Denari Boykin to deal with that time. Turnover gives it back to the gents as Singleton operates one-on-one with Filio. Nice step through, but great recovery. Devin Filio showing off his size and length defensively. Red gives back to Boykin. He will fire from the wing, but it's well long. Being mauled on the other side was Devin Filio. AJ Hall with some words for the referee. As he was on the backside, I believe it was Mirage trying to box out Devin Filio, who kind of went up and over the top. But he certainly has the size advantage over Mirage. Carter catches that on the outside. Boykin again in the middle of the paint, but that jumper from about 12 feet is too strong. Singleton controls, gives to Hall. Did not play in the first half of this team's game one victory. Came off the bench in the second half, had 11 points in just 8 minutes. Helped lift them to a win by just 1 point over the Shriner Mountaineers. Had his number called earlier, both yesterday and now today, as he made a very nice pass on the inside. Singleton's shot was up at the rim, already hit the backboard. So it's a goaltending violation against Colorado College. Colorado again down by four. Ball having been pitched out all the way, this time deflected. So much size and length on the perimeter for the Gents. Mirage trying to find some sort of an opening, eventually will back it out to Singleton, who's going to receive a screen from Greenleaf on the outside. Greenleaf, size advantage against Romero. He's going to try and back him down. Said kicks to Beverly in the corner. AJ Hall, nice pump fake, got Ty Hindler off of the ground. And Hall, recognizing that, went straight into his body to draw the foul. Just Hindler's first foul here for Colorado. And a clean half being played by both sides right now. Four fouls each way. That ball being skied, trying to find Mirage, but it was Gavin Carter intercepting it. He had to leap in the air to do so, and he had his legs taken out. He went to the ground hard, a little slow to get up, but his teammates will help him do so. Carter, the freshman, 5'11 guard out of Massachusetts, has been very impressive past three games in his role off the bench. Been very patient, showing a lot of poise, handling the rock outside of this Colorado College offense. Gives to Rueg, who still has 15 seconds. Ran and Sammy Coglo into the game for the Tigers. He got it down low to Filio, tried to operate again. The Tigers trying to spin through some double teams, and in the process, they've lost the ball a couple of times. It's Hall, nice feed down low to Greenleaf, who rolled to the basket. That one hangs there for an eternity and falls off. He's able to gather a rebound, but it was more black jerseys in the vicinity able to tie him up. And Colorado has the benefit of the possession arrow as Nossiger and Price will check back into the game. Off go Filio and Carter. Nossiger comes ahead and catches the ball in the backcourt. Hindler picks up his dribble, but he has Nossiger as an outlet. Sammy Coglo in the middle of the court. Kick to the perimeter. Rueg thought about it for a second, but Collier runs him off the three-point line nicely. Into the corner. Sammy Coglo with the defender in his face leaves it a little bit short. And Hall out and running quickly, but it's one white jersey in the front court versus five black ones. He'll leave that short. As Quentin Beverly was trying to come in and save the possession, and tips it out of bounds. Another stoppage of play with 7:51. Media timeout here. As we'll take a look at the team stats. Now over 12 minutes gone by in half number one of the 2024 Southern Collegiate Athletic Conference Men's Basketball Championship. Centenary continuing their hot shooting. 10 of 19 from the field. Bulk of those looks coming inside. 14 points in the paint, despite the size of Colorado College. Everything on the interior working nicely for the Gents. And the other way, Colorado, maybe a little bit of a change of script. They're struggling from the field, just 6 of 16 overall. But the three-point shooting has been electric, 4 of 7 from outside the arc. Rueggs knocked down a couple of them. Edgar Romero and Gavin Carter each have 1 3-point make. The other side, just 2 3-balls that the Gents have attempted, both of them coming from Seth Thomas. He's 1 of 2 from downtown on the day. And as we mentioned, Seth Thomas has been fantastic across several years here in Shreveport. Just a 33% three-point shooter on the season, 29% in his career, but on very heavy usage, averaging 16 points a game on almost 45% shooting from the rest of the field. Rueg, nice bounce pass, gets it into the short corner. Hindler from the mid-range, that one will dribble in, hit the front iron, but he got the friendly roll. Cuts it back to a two-point game. Collier will advance it to Beverly, but he'll pull a deep one. Collier got it back and left it a little short. Beverly got in there, gave the Gents an opportunity to come away with an offensive rebound, but as he ripped it away, ball found itself in the hands of Colorado. Ryan Semikoglu goes down low to Price, challenged there by Greenleaf. Nostiger on the other side, able to clean things up. Got the tip in, put back, and again ties us at 24. Nostiger for the Tigers has 5 points. Greenleaf out front, gives to Singleton, wide open. He'll pull the trigger, and he knocks it home. Singleton leading the way for Centenary. He has 10. Ryan Semikoglu down low to Price, operating out of it. Rueg on the outside again. He knocks it home. He has the answer. 27 all, back and forth here in the Gold Dome. That one across to Singleton. See if he can respond again. This time he'll go to the basket. Feeds down low to Greenleaf. Pressure there. Got it on the rim, but it'll bounce out. Nofziger will get tagged with that personal foul as he was trying to recover. Nice entry pass. Singleton found himself right around the free throw line. Recognized Greenleaf on the block. Greenleaf stepping up to the line for his first 2 free throws of the day. About a 50% free throw shooter for Centenary this season. Leaves that one short. And Seth Thomas will come back onto the court for the Gents. Off goes Singleton, who has provided a very nice scoring burst off the bench. 10 points leads all scorers, but Scott Rueg trailing close behind. He has 9. He's a perfect 3 of 3 from the field. All 3 of those coming from beyond the arc. He will inbound the ball now after Greenleaf's second attempt at the line was good. Gives the 1-point advantage back to Centenary. Chicago gave to Hindler there. As the Centenary bench called for a carry, Hindler from straight away catches, and that one off a little bit to the left, but Semikoglu able to track it down, keep his feet in bounds. Hindler operating on the inside, gives it to Nostiger. Close quarters for Colorado right now, and eventually they lose the ball because of it. Seth Thomas coming in transition, goes at Hindler, discards him, but can't finish off the glass. A nice look. He created the separation he wanted, but he just couldn't get it to go down. Semikoglu will catch. He'll control. Up top to Hindler, across to Rueg. Rueg down low as Price has it. Semikoglu trying to give it over to the opposite block. A little bit of a triangle offense right inside the paint almost for Colorado College. As Price is caught on the block a couple of times, Orion Semikoglu has been playing at that free throw line area as there's single digits on the shot clock. 5 remaining, perfectly weighted pass over the top. Great feed inside. Price had his man sealed and Rueg didn't panic. With just 5 remaining on the shot clock, fed that one in over the top very nicely. And now, for the first time today, Colorado College has the lead 29-28, but Greenleaf trying to take it back, and he'll do so. Steps through right after getting around Price. Nice finish at the basket as Sammy Coglo again coming forward. He'll get it, and Rueg will go quickly. Feed to Price on the inside. He'll back down Greenleaf, but Greenleaf, not fazed, will rip it away off the leg of Price. He's fired up by his own defensive stop. Gives a little bit of a yell. Ball back to Centenary as soon as they regain their lead. Collier brings it across for the Gents. Nice crossover. It'll free him up from the mid-range, and he drops it through. Beautiful high arcing mid-range jumper from Craig Collier right there. Hindler with the ball, gives to Ryan Semikoglo. Kick to the corner. Greenleaf just a minute too late as Nofziger will take advantage, gets all the way to the rim, and finishes around the arms of the Centenary defenders. Bear in the front court trying to go baseline, but Semikoglo cuts him off. Seth Thomas opposite wing, a little bit short. Missed that one off the front of the iron. Rueg brings it across again for Colorado College. Nofziger thinks about the shot from three. Rueg facing a couple of defenders on the block. Nofziger opposite side, waited for the defender to buy him. Perfectly timed it underneath the basket, was able to finish. Asher Nofziger now has 9 points for Colorado College, tying his teammate Scott Rueg as Greenleaf gives off to Thomas, who thinks about it a couple of times, eventually passes it off, and Rueg keeps it in bounds. Off the deflection, he'll go to the rim, challenged by Collier, but he'll finish despite it. Great anticipation defensively from Scott Rueg right there. Got the deflection, the ball stayed in bounds, and he raced to the other side for the transition layup. He now leads all scorers with 11. There'll be a timeout called here in Shreveport. Just a brief break as Colorado now ahead 35-32. 30-second break as both benches standing on the court at the moment. Coach Dorsey not liking that cross-court pass that was read well by Scott Rueg. Mentioned it earlier. He was tasked with a very, very tall challenge, having to guard Jacob Harvey of Trinity University. Harvey shooting well over 40% from three-point territory on the season on 7 attempts per game, a very large sample size. Rueg, though, holding him to single digits, doing a great job of just running the shooter off the three-point line all day long yesterday. Didn't have the largest offensive contributions for this Colorado College squad. He added 13 points, which was second highest on the squad. But it was really those defensive contributions that made the big difference in what was a one-point victory. Centenary, all weekend long, though, it's been a balanced effort. Win over Shriner, mentioned that Thomas had 20, Collier 12, Singleton 12, and Hall 11. Four players in double digits in that affair as Thomas brings it across, and Colorado College bench unhappy. Thought he lost the dribble a little bit, forced him to carry it, but they don't get the call as Greenleaf steps through as Carter was pressuring him, help defense. Seth Thomas very narrowly loses that one out of bounds, but he'll fade and leaves it off the rim. Greenleaf crashing the boards hard, but tips it to Gavin Carter, who will control for Colorado. Loses his dribble in the backcourt, gets it across with still 3 seconds to spare. Gives to Rueg up top, back to Carter. Thought about the deep three. Boykin in the corner now, drives by the defense, but met at the rim. Quinton Beverly had hands on the basketball, and it's properly identified by the referee as a jump ball. Boykin really trying to force the issue right there, but had a lot of white jerseys in front of him. Nice play defensively by Centenary, and they'll get rewarded with the possession arrow. Seth Thomas checks out. AJ Hall back into the game for the Gents. Singleton gives it in to Collier. Being defended full court right now by Gavin Carter. Collier gets it across the timeline, plenty of time to spare, but loses the ball now. Great pressure on the outside by Carter, but Greenleaf quickly on the inside. He goes to the rim, but can't finish on the left side. Used his right hand, and it just rolled off the iron. Colorado coming the other way. Boykin will give off to Rueg. Corner for Nofziger. Greenleaf quickly in his face, loses the dribble. It's a little loose there. He puts the shot up without a penalty, but he can't get it to go, and a Singleton crash. Boykin came through his back. That's Denari Boykin's second personal foul. Now the sixth on Colorado College. So one more, and Centenary will be in the bonus, but 2:07 remains here in the first half. Singleton brings it across. Scoring leader for the Gents. Operating in the middle of the floor, gets Boykin off his feet and nicely finishes that one from 10. He claps his hands as he gets himself going, drawing the Gents back within one. He now has 12, matches his number. Boykin on the outside going against Singleton, go through his chest all the way to the rim, but there was a whistle away from the ball. Referee going to call Singleton for a foul before Boykin was leaving his feet for the shot, I believe. It's the sixth team foul. Boykin standing at the free throw line. A bit of a delay, but they will score the basket. Boykin finishes that one nicely. A very strong move to the basket. Went right through the chest of the defender. And he'll finish the three-point play and extend the lead back out to 4. Singleton, ball in his hands again. Pressured by Carter. He'll be trapped at half court. Tip that one into the backcourt. Collier will gather and bring it back across. Skies one to Quentin Beverly, who elevates and controls. 15 seconds now on the shot clock. Coach Dorsey yells in from the sideline. Singleton will have a shot and he'll knock it home. A broken play offensively, but Singleton can do no wrong. Taking matters into his own hands. He has 15. Sami Koglu brings it across the court. Carter, opposite block, has Dittman. Closed down nicely as Orion Semikoglu again catches, gives to Dittman in the corner. Nofziger on the elbow, outside to Rueg. Thought about the three. He'll kick to Carter with single digits on the shot clock. Just 5 seconds remaining. Rueg pulls it, and he can't miss! Unconscious Scott Rueg. A perfect 4-for-4 from the outside. Colorado College coming on strong here after they were a little bit slow out the gates. Staved off an initial burst off the tip-off from Centenary. We now lead this game by 4 points with 45 seconds remaining in the first half of play. Better than 50% from the field and now 60% from three-point territory, 6 of 10. From long range. Centenary on the other side, still very respectable. Nearly 52% from the field, 50% from three-point territory, and each of these teams at least 80% from the free throw line. Quickly out of that timeout, Singleton will get it in and get the ball back. Only a few possessions will remain. Colorado College can very likely have the final shot of the first half as the game clock nears 30 seconds. Beverly will catch with 15 remaining on the shot. Once a screen, he'll get it from Greenleaf. The pressure is Trey Crawford providing length on the outside. Hall's shot is too long. Greenleaf tried to tip it out, but Sami Koglu there for the board. With 15 seconds remaining in the game in this half, feed down low to Dittman. Colorado College had the opportunity for the last shot, but Singleton rattles it away. just a little bit out of sync as he was trying to come back in transition. He loses it out of bounds on the sideline, and now Colorado will have the opportunity for the last shot. 6.1 seconds remaining on the clock. Sincoglo gets it into Rueg, trapped as he comes across. He'll lose it. Collier wildly throws it ahead. Singleton at the buzzer. That one's a heave. It's good! Singleton with a huge shot. Near half-court heave, and it'll give the Gents some momentum into the locker room. 18 first-half points for Tykeem Singleton. 6 of 7, now 7 of 8 from the field, and a perfect 3 for 3 from range. Credit Craig Collier for a wild assist right there as that one was poked away. Rueg going quickly, trying to get it into the front court. Was dribbling along the ground. Collier picking it up and spinning and heaving. Singleton had to sky to outjump some defenders, but he came down, somehow put that one through. What a shot, and what a first half of play. Everything we hoped for and more in the championship game here in the Southern Collegiate Athletic Conference. 14:30 remaining in our halftime break. We'll step away for just a moment on the broadcast. You're not going to want to go anywhere. 20 more minutes of championship caliber basketball on its way. buzzer sounds, and both of these teams back out on the court. 20 more minutes to decide the Southern Collegiate Athletic Conference men's basketball champ. Colorado College comes into this second half with a 1-point lead. They'll get the basketball first. Oscar will get it in the corner. He'll launch from three. He's going to leave it a little bit short, and Thomas will control the rebound. He skies for that one and goes straight at Boykin. He's going to get called for an offensive foul. Jannari Boykin racing back in transition, trying to get himself in front of Seth Thomas. And he did so just well enough as Thomas used his off arm. A lot of momentum right there, and the two at half court. A little bit of extracurricular, but Thomas puts his arm on Boykin in defense, and Boykin throws it off. Ruegg gives to Hindler, defended on the outside. Back to Ruegg, now to Nofziger. Looking inside, he finds Hindler. That one's tipped and taken by Thomas. Steals leader in the conference, straight to the basket, but he can't finish there. Ruegg getting back nicely to defend that shot, and he left it short. Boykin will go baseline, runs into Quentin Beverly. A little bit too much juice from Jannari Boykin that time. Takes the charge, and then he gives one away. Quentin Beverly moving his feet very nicely right there. First half of play was action-packed. Tykeem Singleton ended us off in incredible fashion. Huge three at the buzzer gave him a game-high 18 points on the other side. Scott Ruegg, perfect from the field, 5-for-5. 4-for-4 from three. He has 14 for the Tigers as Greenleaf catches. For a Centenary team that's playing well on this end of the court, Collier loses it just a bit, but regains and gives to Bear on the near side. He'll go to the middle, trying to step through. Gets Philly off his feet nicely and finishes with the step through finally. Centenary has not had any opportunities for second chance points in that first half. They were out-rebounded pretty significantly, 21-7 advantage for the Tigers. No offensive rebounds for the Gents. The Gents, despite that, have the lead. Ruegg trying to take it back, but he misses that one. Maybe cut a centimeter of the rim. He's gonna get some air ball chance nonetheless here in the Gold Dome. Centenary faithful showing out in numbers this Sunday afternoon. Another beautiful day here in Shreveport, Louisiana. Seth Thomas is trying to take advantage of it here in the Gold Dome. Give the Centenary Gents a conference championship title. Greenleaf has it in his hands, crosses over, does not give to Beverly. Instead, he'll go to the basket against Nofziger. Up and under, he can't finish. It rolled out off the left side of the rim as Hindler will bring it back in transition, trying to regain the lead for Colorado. He'll give to Carter. Cross to Ruegg, back to Carter. Opposite corner, Hindler will go quickly, drives baseline, rises up. He goes to the ground. He had his legs taken out from under him. A lot of contact on that jumper, but no foul called. And as he got batted out towards the near sideline, a couple of players hustling for it. Nofziger and Collier, who picked themselves up back into the field of play. Referees will say it went off of Collier. Colorado generating a second chance opportunity here. Ruegg gives to Carter. Cross-court pass, nicely handled by Filio right there. Somehow Gavin Carter snuck that one through the wickets of the defense. Filio catching it cleanly. Defense closed cleanly, or quickly, I should say, but not cleanly. Send him to the free throw line. Already 2 minutes gone by here in the second half. Two personal fouls against the Gents as Filio's first attempt at the line is up and good. So he ties this ball game at 42. Devin Filio, the junior from Aurora, Colorado, tucks his jersey in and receives the ball for his second free throw attempt. Less than 50% on the year, and that one is strong, so he goes 1-for-2. Collier, Beverly has it. Greenleaf, Thomas, and Bear starting five for Coach Dorsey still out there on the court for the Gems. Greenleaf will send Beverly through, gives to Thomas, gets to the middle of the floor, rises up, up and under, but just can't get enough to sneak it over the rim. In large part because of the contact as he was driving. That one gonna go against Asher Nofziger, who picks up his second personal foul. Only one player each way experiencing a little bit of foul difficulty at the moment. As Thomas is gonna roll that one in. For Colorado College, it was Boykin who just picked up his third personal with that offensive foul a few moments ago. Ty Hindler's gonna come off the court. Edgar Romero back on, wearing number four for the Tigers. So Thomas puts the second one up, and that one's also good. 2-point advantage for the Gents as they continue to apply some full court pressure. For these Gents, Gerald Mirage, who has three personal fouls and is currently on the bench for Coach Dorsey. Pressure on the outside. Carter trapped there, but gets it away cleanly. Nofziger, opposite wing, Brueg. Corner for Romero, but the defense closes quickly. This one 10 feet outside the three-point line with still just about 10 seconds on the shot clock. Tipped on the inside. Thomas tries to corral it, but as he was dribbling it, he hit that baseline. So exactly 10 seconds on the shot clock. That's all Colorado will have to work with on this possession. Straight into Rueck, top of the key. No shot there, but he gets through and knocks one down. Great move to free himself up. He rises just inside that three-point line and knots us up again at 44. He has 16 to lead the way for Colorado College. Thomas gonna use the screen from Greenleaf and hit him when he rolls. On the inside against Nofziger. Nofziger standing his ground and then closes a little bit too much at the last moment. That's a couple of personal fouls that Asher Nofziger has picked up in the last few possessions. That's going to be his third personal foul. It'll send Greenleaf to the free throw line, and it's going to prompt a change. Adrian Price headed to the bench for Coach Conroe and these Colorado College Tigers. The other way, Coach Dorsey has also sent a man to the bench. It looks like it'll be Jared Mirage, who also is sporting three personal fouls. And he sets, gets the first one away, but he misses it long. High bounce off the back iron, but does not fall through. Mirage comes onto the court for Collier for Sintner. As I just mentioned, did not gather any offensive rebounds in that first half. Wasn't hurt too badly by that fact. They took great care of the basketball through the first 20 minutes. Only four turnovers as opposed to 12 for Colorado College in the opening 20. That one inside to Price, who corrals it. Greenleaf trying to recover. Seth Thomas also in the vicinity. Frustration from this Centenary crowd. They thought that there was contact with the basketball, but the referee is seeing contact between the bodies, and Adrian Price gonna head to the free throw line because of it. Gets loud here in the Gold Dome, but Adrian Price unfazed on the first shot. It's good for the 6'7" junior out of Aurora. Second one is pending. Opportunity to push this lead back to two for Colorado. It's up, but it's no good. Long. Filio over the top, though. Corrals an offensive board. Gives to Carter. Again to Price on the inside. Trying to back down Thomas. Up over the top, and it rattles in. Put it up on the rim. Took a couple of bounces, but eventually falls through. And Colorado taking advantage of that second chance opportunity on the offensive glass. Singleton back into the game. He'll go to the rim. Staves off the defender and finishes. Impressive finish. Extending with that right arm to keep it away from Devin Filio. And he rolls it off the rim on the near side. Singleton starting the second half on the bench like he did coming out of the gates, but still not missing a beat. Up to 20 points, make it 21 as his free throw rattles home and he finishes the three-point play. Rueg trying to find a man. He eventually does find Carter, gets it ahead to Romero. Romero hard to the rim, and he finishes nicely off the glass. Great touch by Edgar Romero, who hustles back in transition. Mirage over to Thomas. Thomas, one-on-one, trying to back down the smaller Rueg. Get inside the paint. Rueg off his feet, and he finishes on the inside through the contact. Seth Thomas. Scott Rueg surrendering some major size right there. Seth Thomas, forward for these gents, makes the veteran move of backing him down on the inside. Gets all the way across the lane, finishes strong with his right hand to bring us to 49 all. He'll have a free throw opportunity coming out of this timeout. Stoppage comes with 15:46. Our first media timeout of the second half. Give us the opportunity to take a look at some of the numbers for each of these teams' players. Rueg leading the way for Colorado. The next two leading scorers are Nofziger and Boykin, who are both on the bench with three personal fouls each. The other way, it's Singleton, who has 21, Seth Thomas with 9. Greenleaf, he's got 7, but he now also has 3 personals. So some foul trouble both ways. Maybe in some more significant places for Colorado College, however, since they're second and third leading scorers on today's affair. Right now for Coach Conroe, he's running with a 5. Romero, Rueg, Filio, Carter, and Price. The other way, it's Thomas, Beverly, Mirage, Singleton, and Greenlee. Coach Dorsey not being fazed, allowing his players to play through their foul trouble at the moment. Both teams set again. Seth Thomas getting ready for just one free throw attempt, trying to finish the three-point play and give the gents the lead. First one is up, and it is good. Back into the game now, Ryan Semikoglu back on for Colorado College. Hard to miss in those purple shoes. Romero catches this one. Some nice pressure being provided by the gents on the inbound, but still no issue for Colorado College right there. As Rueg will give to the corner, lofty pass, reaches its intended target. Cross court pass to Carter. Corner, Romero puts the 3 up. High arcer is no good. Semikoglu had a hand on it, but Singleton will control it and bring it back. One-on-one with Scott Rueg. He'll defer all the way out top to Greenleaf with 20 seconds on the shot. Singleton again. He'll receive the screen, but stumbles a bit off the hedge. Gives to Seth Thomas, who now has 10 seconds, going one-on-one against Orion Semikoglu. Adrian Price coming over, taking that ball away. He rips it out originally, but as he goes to the ground with it, the gents able to hit the deck as well and tie him up. St. Mary will retain possession, but will get just 3 seconds on the shot clock to put something up. A little bit of a delay as Seth Thomas wants to wipe the basketball off, and the court needs to be cleaned up as well. Court is good. Ball taking just a little bit longer. Colorado College coaching staff, assistants on the bench, instructing the team to watch the back door. This one will go to Greenleaf out top. Has to go quickly. He does from the mid-range. Misses everything, though. Got the backboard, just no iron. So the buzzer sounds, and it'll be a turnover there for the gents. Carter comes to the basketball, navigates into some open space right in front of Rueg. Gets the ball back to Carter now. One-on-one out top with Mirage. Kick to the corner, Romero. Enough space to get this one off, and he gets it in. Edgar Romero, good from the corner that time. Providing a nice spark off the bench for Colorado College. As Centenary falls behind now by two, but Mirage says not for long. Hangs nicely in the air and finishes off the glass to knot this one up again. Middle of the court, Sammy Coglu had that briefly, gives to Carter, ahead to Rueg. Scrambling are these gents on the outside as Orion, Sammy Coglu got the defender to jump by. Rueg into the corner, Romero again. No good this time, rimmed in and out. Singleton coming up the court quickly, trying to attack the defense before it can get set, but he gets shut off from the baseline. Rueg running some size, a nice up and under move. That one rolls in. He can't miss anything at the moment. I think he hit the front side of the rim, but somehow the English on it spun in. Sammy Coglu dealing with pressure at half court. Nice cross court pass, and he gets the ball back. Great ball movement there. Rueg spotted Price. And it was Sammy Coglu crashing down the lane line who finishes that play for Colorado. Seth Thomas has the ball tipped. Nice defense, good hands from Orion. Sammy Coglu right there. But now Thomas going to back down the smaller defender. Tries to spin off. Sammy Coglu staying right behind him. Mirage with now just seven on the shot clock, but he's going to go to the ground. Gavin Carter defending there, but can't do so without fouling. Six personal fouls already for Colorado College. Just one more, and the gents are going to be in the bonus with still 13-10 remaining in the second half. Mirage comes out front to catch. Shot clock reset, so now they're down to 15. Mirage gives to Greenleaf, top of the key, looking to the other wing. He'll give to Singleton, steps back. Cannot hoist, just seven on the shot. Greenleaf has to go, and he does so against Price. Gets to his spot, just can't finish, left it short. Rueg ahead, finds Romero somehow. Seth Thomas had his arms outstretched, and just barely missed him. Carter gives to the corner. Sammy Coglu thought about it, but defense closes. Back out top, 15 seconds on the shot. Romero will pull, defender in his face, and he leaves it long. Mirage gathers the long rebound, uses it to run out. He gets pressured. Singleton, opposite wing, he'll pull. He puts it home. Tykeem Singleton off the bench, leading the way for Centenary. He's up to 26 in this championship game. And the gents need every bit they can get. Rueg too strong. Price perfectly positioned. Careens off the glass hard, straight into his arms though. And he gets the second chance points. Second chance points, a category Colorado is leading 11-0 in at the moment. Seth Thomas backing down Sammy Coglu. Sammy Coglu did everything right on that possession. Seth Thomas just too much to handle. Fades away over the top nicely and banks it home. Just great touch off of the glass for the forward. Get a timeout here with 11:40 remaining. Centenary winning this second half currently by 4 points, so they're out ahead by three. They came into the second set of 20 minutes trailing by one. It's Coach Conero and his team trailing. Wants a spark sooner rather than later. So Denari Boykin just walked to the scorer's table. He'll come back into this game dealing with those three personal fouls. His presence currently being missed. Still very impressive shooting splits for each of these squads. 50, 40, 70, bare minimum both ways. Centenary who shot about half the number of three balls as Colorado College, 5 for 9 still. Good for about 56%. Currently, both of these benches providing a necessary spark. Centenary, of course, with Singleton giving them 26, winning this battle as they have 28. Just two bench points for the Gents outside of Singleton. The other way, 21 from the Tiger substitutes. And it's a handful of Tiger substitutes currently joining the lone starter, Denari Boykin. Sammy Coglu, Carter, Dittman, and Price rounding out the five on the court for the Tigers. Carter makes his move to come in and retrieve the basketball. A trap will head to the corner. He gets it away. Still 5 seconds to get the ball across. Sammy Coglu will go with a couple of seconds to spare to get the job done. Catches on the wing. Seth Thomas comes out aggressively. Kick to the corner. Dittman catches there, but Singleton right in his face. Beverly nearly playing in the passing lane on that one. Sammy Coglu somehow gets that through the defenders, puts it up on the rim, but it falls off. Good look, high arcing floater hung up there for a moment. As it heads out of bounds, it'll stay with Colorado on this end of the court. That last timeout was called by Coach Conroe, but now another stoppage. First one naturally under 12 minutes, so there'll be another media timeout. Scott Rueg is set to check back into the game for Colorado. On the other side, some names we haven't called as frequently for Centenary today. Braden Board, big forward, who's played on the inbounder in the full court press for the Gents in the last couple of days. Provides a ton of size. 6'6", senior, listed as a guard out of Rain, Louisiana. Has not been out there quite as frequently. Coach Dorsey, happy with the group he's running with. AJ Hall, another name that last couple of days has been a huge benefactor for the Gents. Right now, it's been mostly the starting five and Tykeem Singleton. They're certainly getting the job done for Centenary. At the moment, they lead this one by three. 11-12 remaining in championship game number one. The SCAC Women's Basketball Championship will be decided right after the conclusion of this one, scheduled for 2 o'clock. And I got a feeling that might run a little bit late here in game one. Carter gets it inbounded to Dittman. Down low to Price, trying to back down Greenleaf. Pulls through, but he misses it off the iron. Dittman somehow takes it away from Greenleaf, though. Carter thought about the three. Kick to Rueg. Corner. Dittman gets the defender off the ground. Have to pull it back across to Boykin. Still 10 seconds on the shot clock. Dittman almost left the ground. The referees say he doesn't, but he threw it away. Centenary will come back the other direction. Singleton crosses over, now operating in the middle of the floor. Loose with the dribble just a bit, so he'll pull it out and give to Greenleaf. Greenleaf thinking about challenging Dittman. He will. Tries to go through his chest, but Dittman stands his ground. Kick to Thomas, however. Left the three ball short. Kick outside. Beverly and Rueg. Cup. Top Mirage to Greenleaf. Greenleaf now guarded by Price as Thomas and Dittman will go at it on the far side. Better matchup here for Colorado, but Thomas still taking advantage. He frees himself. It was Price who had to come over and help after a nice spin move freed up Seth Thomas. Missed long, but Price hit him and he went to the ground. That's now 7 team fouls against Colorado College. With 10:16 remaining, Centenary Gents will spend the rest of this game in the bonus. So Thomas was shooting, however, so he'll have two no matter what right here. First one rims out. And Dittman will head to the bench for Colorado. Sammy Coglu back into the game. Delay there, but Seth Thomas finally gets the ball back for his second attempt. Wyatt here, outside of Gavin Carter, trying to get some traction with his shoes. squeaking does not bother Thomas. He knocks the second one down. And Centenary continues to pressure full court. Mirage out top against Rueg, who will hand off to Carter, but get it back right away. Into the corner, Boykin catches there and is immediately trapped. Tries to get it away. It was tipped, and he gathers his own loose ball, but blocked as he went to the rim. Rejected by the Gents. Mirage operating against Rueg on the offensive end now, who gives to Singleton. A little bit of a push by Boykin, who's coming out to challenge. Singleton gathering, trying to go. He gets the advantage, the step, and the finish. Swings his arm. He's fired up. He's got 28. Huge performance from Tykeem Singleton in the SCAC championship game. And the crowd here in Shreveport is loving it. Those last two extend Centenary's lead just a bit further, now out to 6 points. Less than 10 minutes remaining. Sammy Coglu is going to catch. He'll pull, but well off the mark. Misses that one long. Forced from the corner. Mirage coming back the opposite direction. Fans on their feet here in the Gold Dome. As Singleton operating one-on-one. Goes to the basket again. Hangs, and that one falls off. Good look. But Rueg defending him nicely right there. Staying in front best he could. Carter gets this one back and brings it across the timeline. Rueg out top. He's gone a little quiet here in the last several minutes. Hasn't attempted a shot. 6 for 8 on the day. 4 for 6 from three. Started perfect, but 0 for his last two. It's that last ball. Trying to make its way into the corner. Gets tipped out of bounds. Tigers still with 15 seconds on the shot clock. Cross-court pass, Romero will pull. High Archer is well off the mark. That one an air ball. Sammy Coglu catches. Just 5 seconds, Rueg again. Can't cash that one in. Gavin Carter, Sky, tried to make the tip shot, but we put it off the underside of the rim. Thomas, transition, racing, misses it. A little bit too much momentum and hard off the backboard. Nice pass inside. Sammy Coglu had it stripped, though. Singleton got to it. Sammy Coglu dives on the ground. Finds it again in the corner. Slow down. Price on the inside being hugged as he had Singleton sealed off. Nice recognition from Orion Sammy Coglu right there. Saw his big man, tried to give it to him. Probably a wise play from Singleton. He doesn't commit the foul there. An easy 2 points for Adrian Price. Still just the fourth team foul for Centenary. Rueg catches, doesn't pull originally. Kick to Sammy Coglu. He'll get into the paint. Nice speed. Gives it off to Price. Defense had to close space on Sammy Coglu. He recognized that they left Price wide open on the block. Gives him the feed, and Price went straight up to the rim. Had his arm grabbed in route. So he'll head to the free throw line for two. Crowd in the Gold Dome letting Price hear it. His first one is up and it's no good, and they love it here in Shreveport. Change coming for Coach Dorsey. Greenleaf will check off with 8:06 remaining, and AJ Hall back into the game. As Price receives the basketball again, goes through his routine. Second ball is up and on its way. Missed that one. Count. With that make, Price will check out of the basketball game. It's going to be Trey Crawford who comes back on. He's going to defend in the backcourt. Seth Thomas now has it. The paint wide open. He'll go to the rim, swirls around, just refused to fall through. Recognize that Crawford was defending in the backcourt. Seth Thomas just took off, got into the paint where there was no shot blocker. Did not hurt Colorado College, however. Operate with 15. Rueg catches. Corner for Sammy Coglu. Fender in his face. He leaves it short. Well defended by Singleton right there as Mirage comes back, gives to Hall. He will hoist, and he knocks it in. Turns to the crowd, and he has him fired up. AJ Hall extends the lead to 8. Sami Koglu back the other way. Carter up top, off to Rueg. Inside, Sami Koglu trying to break down the zone. Goes straight through the chest of Seth Thomas. He'll get called for the offensive foul. He goes to the ground, Sami Koglu does. Holds his leg there briefly, but he pops back up. But Sitnary fired up. They have been wonderful here in the second half, especially in the last 4 minutes. AJ Hall knocking down that big three-pointer in transition just moments ago. And Centenary ballooning their lead out to 8. Evan Filio heads to the scorer's table. He'll come back on for Colorado. Both of these teams playing for a bid to the NCAA postseason tournament. Whoever wins today likely would not have made it otherwise. So we're going to have a bid thief on our hands. Got 7:13 remaining, and then we can say for sure whether it'll be the Gents of Centenary or the Tigers of Colorado College. But right now, Centenary holding the edge. Colorado will have some work to do down the stretch. Tykeem Singleton, 28 points on 11 of 13 shooting, a perfect 4-for-4 from three-point territory, 2-for-2 at the charity stripe. He's been absolutely sensational. He leads all scorers. Doubled up his teammate, more than doubled up his teammate, Seth Thomas. Second on the team with 13 points. The other way, Scott Rueg, still leading Colorado College. He has 16. Nofsker with 9, Price with 9, Romero with 8, Boykin with 7. They'll need someone to step up down the stretch. They've continued to work the basketball on the offensive end. But Centenary making everything very difficult for them with their 1-3-1 zone. Singleton will catch this one and get play resumed. Gives off to Thomas straight away. Working against Evan Filio. In the paint now. One-on-one. Hops to a stop on the block, but has to kick out. Good defense there. Crawford gets pushed off. Nice job from the long big man, moving his feet and staying in front right there. Very impressive mobility from big 6'9" Trey Crawford. Draws that offensive foul. Now 6.5 for Centenary, so one more will put Colorado College in the bonus. Scott Rueg ready to get this one triggered in bounds. Gavin Carter coming to the ball, but it'll be Trey Crawford who catches and gives to Rueg, to Carter, who wants his teammates to go ahead and advance. He'll work one-on-one and then get the ball back as he comes across the timeline. Being pressured about 10 feet beyond the three-point line. Absolutely no rest for these Tigers. Beverly switches on to him. Kick back, opposite wing, deep three, leaves it short. Beverly skied. Filio trying to punch that one out, but too much contact on the body right there, and Devin Filio will pick up the foul on the loose ball. Since it was a loose ball foul, Quinn Beverly is going to make the long walk to the other end of the court to shoot free throws in the 1-1. Quinn Beverly, as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, was perfect from the free throw line, 4-for-4 yesterday. It's been the same so far today on his first two attempts. His third is up, and he puts it in. Front end of the 1-1 is good. He earns a second attempt. He's got 5 now for the Gents, as Asher Nofsker is going to check in Filio off after picking up his second personal foul. Perhaps a little bit of an offense for defense substitution right there as Ashton Ostriger comes back into the game. He has 9 points. And they're going to need some contribution from him as they now trail by 10. He'll catch and get back to Rueg. Singleton nearly stumbles and falls right there. Ball goes into Nosker, Carter, Rueg. Pressured again on the outside. 15 remains on the shot clock. A lot of time being eaten up on all of Colorado College's possessions. Rueg steps through, misses that one. A touch on the rim, likely to be a goaltend as it was still on the cylinder. And that is the call. Trey Crawford came skying in, trying to get a touch on the basketball. Instead, he had to grab the rim, trying to keep himself on balance. Unfortunately for Colorado College, that one fell back through. Referee has identified it as a goaltend. Beth Thomas, at the top of the key against Ashton Ostriger. Pulls it back, trying to operate. He gets the step, closes. A.J. Hall in the corner, but he misses it. Off the back rim, it's Mirage trying to run it down and save it, but it was already out of bounds. Greenleaf checking into the game for Hall. Rueg gives to Carter. Over to Rueg, into the middle of the court. Nosker caught there. Hindler back in for Colorado. He has it in the corner. He's being hounded there into Price, who gets it ripped away. Seth Thomas took that ball right out of his mitts. And he'll defer after the nice defensive play. Takes a little bit of a breather near half court. Now they'll induce the offense, still with 20 seconds left. Catches it as Nostiger tried to fight through his back. That'll be four personal fouls on Asher Nostiger. And on top of that, it sends Seth Thomas to the free throw line. Already a double-digit advantage for Centenary. Seth Thomas has the opportunity to expand it. That one's good. It was the 10th personal right there on Colorado College. So it's the double bonus the rest of the way for Centenary. Nostiger with that fourth personal foul will have to come out of the game. For Ryan Semikoglu that checks back in, playing on the block. As this second free throw attempt is up and a little bit long. So an 11-point game now. Centenary leading this one as we close in on just 5 minutes remaining. Plenty of time here for Colorado. They've gone cold here in the second half. This one kicked to Carter on the near wing. Back inside, Semikoglu. Enough space to catch, but not a ton of space to operate. Centenary closing gaps very quickly, but closed too tightly to Ryan Semikoglu's body right there. Foul's called. That one's on Singleton. It'll be his fourth. Coach Dorsey sending a player, A.J. Hall, to the table. Singleton giving thumbs up to the bench. Doesn't want to come out of this game, but he will anyways. Boykin comes back in on the other side. Hindler will take his leave of absence. This one ruled on the ground, so it is a 1-1 for Ryan Semikoglu. First is up, and it's long, and it bounces off, but Price able to gather an offensive rebound. Much needed there for Colorado. Boykin will hoist from three, but he misses that one a little wide to the left. Very stout defense being played here in the second half, where Colorado has mustered just 16 points after a very impressive 41-point first half. To Thomas out front against Ryan Semikoglu. Has the advantage as the defense comes. Boykin kicks a corner. Hall had that one blocked. Boykin recovered very nicely. So he was trying to provide a little help as Seth Thomas went to the rim. Rueg pulls up but misses it short. Boykin skying for the rebound on the inside. Puts that one, kind of wedges it off the back iron, and it'll drop in. Back to single digits. 68-59. Just 4 minutes remain here in Shreveport as Thomas gives to Mirage. Goes over to Greenleaf up top. Thomas on the outside. Greenleaf in the vicinity, but he will exit the picture. Single digits, just 8 on the shot clock. Seth Thomas stepping through, cannot find the angle. Misses that one off the side of the backboard. Boykin up the court quickly, elevates to the rim. He had A.J. Hall underneath him. It'll be a blocking foul against Sintenary. Boykin will have a couple of free throw opportunities out of our final media timeout. Take one last break here in Shreveport. As A.J. Hall picked up just his first personal foul, but now 8 team fouls against Sintenary. So the bonus for Colorado College, still in the 1-1, but nearing double bonus territory. Talked very early on in this one about the size advantage for Colorado. So far, Sintenary doing everything they can to negate what has been a routing on the boards. Tigers out-rebounding the Gents 41-21 in this one. But points in the paint, presence on the inside greater with the Gents. 34-28 advantage in that department. Colorado simply has not been able to get that many great touches on the blocks for the likes of Price or Filio or Crawford. Not for Asher Nofziger either, who spent much of this second half, especially the last 10 minutes on the bench in foul trouble. Picked up his 4th a couple moments ago, so he will remain on the bench for Coach Conero. But right now, Colorado trying to take advantage of the stopped clock. Boykin will step to the free throw line. He'll have 2 attempts as he was in his shooting motion going for the rim in transition. Mirage trying to get the crowd into this one, but it'll not faze Boykin. He puts that first one through. 68-60, cutting into this lead, making an 8-point game as Trey Crawford is set to check back in on a make. Loud here in the Gold Dome, but it goes through anyway. Trey Crawford going to check in. He's going to take out Denari Boykin. So with 3:35 left, looks like Coach Conero already opting to make some defensive-minded substitutions. Scott Rueg pounding the ball. It's Beverly who has it in the backcourt. Singleton will catch now on the wing. Defended there by Crawford. Greenleaf catches, gets back to Singleton. Trying to use Greenleaf as a little bit of a screener right there. Carter maybe got a touch on that one. Mirage operating. Greenleaf now with just 5. He's going to have to go quickly. He recognizes it, tries to spin, but loses his footing. He traveled there. Great defense on the perimeter by Price. Big fella moves his feet very nicely to stay in front. As Colorado induces the turnover, stop ball gives Coach Conero the chance to bring Boykin back on for offense. Sammy Coglu in the middle of the court catches and gives to Rueg. Carter and Rueg back and forth. Middle of the paint, Boykin catches. Defense closes on him though, tries to force it to the rim. Lost it out of bounds. The ref will say it went off of Sintenary. Boykin pleading for a foul call right there, but he will not get it from his appeal. Price trying to seal on the inside. Boykin catching in the corner. That one tipped away. Seth Thomas, another nice deflection. His size and length playing a huge role. A Singleton catch. He'll fire, and he puts it in. He's got 31 as Sintenary pulls back ahead. 10-point advantage with just 2:30 remaining. Carter out top. Sammy Coglu gives it back to him. And Colorado will have to go quickly as Rueg has it on the near side. Down low to Price, operating out of the double team. Nice kick. Carter, a little Euro step, puts it up and in. High lefty floater put it on the rim to give himself a chance, and it fell through. Edgar Romero going to check back into the game for Colorado College. He's knocked down a couple of big threes in this one. He's hit two of them on seven attempts from the outside. Right now, Colorado needs to defend to get some stops, but they also need some makes. They trail this one by eight with 2:17 remaining. It's the 30-second timeout right there. I think Coach Conero took it off of the made shot. On the other side, Centenary taking a little bit more time in their huddle, but finally they will break it and head back out onto the court. It's Thomas, Mirage, Greenleaf, Beverly, and Singleton for the designated home team playing on their home court. The other way, Sammy Coglu, Romero, Rueg, Crawford. The long baseball pass, Singleton has to track it down. He saves it, and miraculously that one works out. Right after five for Colorado is Adrian Price as Greenleaf catches that at the top of the key, hands to Seth Thomas with just about 2 minutes remaining. They're going to take as much of this possession as they can. Coach Dorsey ordering Seth Thomas to take a step back. Now with single digits on the clock, he'll go, gets the defender off the ground, and then he's just going to throw his shoulder into the gut of Orion Sammy Coglu. He did everything he could right there, but ultimately just bit on the shot fake. Just the second personal foul for Orion Sammy Coglu, but it's going to send Seth Thomas to the free throw line. In the last 2 days, he is the man that Centenary has wanted at the charity stripe to close things out. First one is up and it'll fall in. Demonstrates the nice shooting touch right there. And extends this one to nine, a chance to make it double digits again. He has 15, but it's still been Tykeen Singleton show all day long. Second one is on its way. That one is pure. Carter brings the cross, gives to Rueg, back to Carter. Colorado passing around a little more quickly now. They have to go fast. They only have a minute 40 remaining. That one slips out of Rueg's hands. They'll retain possession, 15 seconds. Carter walks into one and he knocks it down. Massive shot from Gavin Carter. Cuts the lead to seven as Colorado needed that one big time. Brief delay getting the ball inbounds. They were being pressured well by Colorado right there, and Coach Dorsey's going to go ahead and take the timeout. Will not risk a 5 second violation. So you can likely hear it on the stream. Crowd here in Shreveport getting quite rowdy at the moment. Just 1 minute and 28 seconds separates these gents from a conference title. It's all positive vibes here in the Gold Dome. As Centenary trying to walk away with a conference championship, a bid to the postseason tournament. And trying to do so in front of their home crowd. Colorado trying to spoil the party. Jeff Thomas getting ready to trigger this one inbounds. Singleton coming open for a moment, but it'll be Quinton Beverly who receives the pass. Checked by Romero in the backcourt. Crawford and Seth Thomas. Crawford closes and Thomas will blow by. Inside the paint, he gets all the way to the rim. Good defense from Crawford though, as Thomas went a little bit too quickly. Coach Dorsey throws his head back. Opportunity there to run some massive seconds off the clock. They fail to do so. A minute five remaining. Nearly a takeaway there for the gents. Carter is the defender off the ground. Sammy Coglu does the same. He'll hoist from three, and he knocks it in. Back-to-back massive three balls for the Tigers, and now they trail by four. Just moments ago, it was 10. Orion Sammy Coglu making that one count. Great defense from Centenary right there. Defenders closing to the three-point line very, very well. Flying at the shooter. Sammy Coglu poised, gathering himself, resetting and knocking that one in. Four-point game. A whirlwind couple of possessions. New life, truly, for Colorado College. Both teams are in the bonus. 30 seconds on the shot clock, 57 or so on the game clock. Imagine that they'll try and defend on this possession without fouling, hoping to get a stop, keep things at four. And then later in this final minute of game time, try and extend things by fouling and sending the Gents to the free throw line. Right now, gonna try and force a turnover in the backcourt. It's Greenleaf who has the ball. One-on-one with Sammy Coglu. Trap comes as soon as he gets it across the timeline. Coach Dorsey very quick to call the timeout in that area of the floor. They advance the ball, avoid the 10-second violation at the very least. 22 seconds remain on the shot clock. Coach Dorsey will avoid the trap that was ensuing right over half court. Right now, it's Thomas, Beverly, Mirage, Singleton, and Greenleaf on the court for the Gents. The other side, it's Romero, Rueg, Crawford, Sammy Coglu, and Carter. Centenary, a wonderful job all day long taking care of the basketball. Just eight turnovers in this one. And on the other bench, Colorado has turned it over 18 times. Centenary, nine more points off turnovers. Pretty big difference in this one today as they lead by four, trying to close things out. Turn to the court. Seth Thomas in front of his own bench, set to get this one inbounded. Yes, Singleton in the corner. Down low to Greenleaf. He'll go up and he'll make the and one. Great decision to get the ball into Tykeem Singleton in the corner. And it looks like there was just a technical foul assessed to the Colorado College bench. Some real frustration, I believe, on that foul call. But the Tigers were late to recover underneath the basket. They got it in to Singleton in the corner. He recognized Greenleaf all alone in the paint. It's Quentin Beverly headed to the charity stripe, likely to attempt a technical free throw. But before we have that, the referees are headed to the table. I'm not sure that the clock here in the arena started. It's still at 46.1 seconds. And I believe that's what it was at out of the last timeout. So a lengthy delay at the end of this game, as the referees will stand at the scorer's table, Denari Boykin will work his way to check in. Now in the Gold Dome, I believe that we will win chance breaking out, carrying over into the Centenary huddle. They'll come back out onto the court. The referee is still at the scorer's table, taking their time with this one. Wanting to make sure that they get the time on the clock right. Colorado College going to need every second that they can get down the stretch. making the job a little bit more difficult. As Greenleaf will have a free throw in addition to a couple of technical free throws coming out of this break. Rotation of referees at the scorer's table. Taking a look at this replay. Coach Dorsey wanting to have a discussion with the referee. But in addition to Greenleaf's free throw, technical free throws will give Centenary the opportunity to extend this lead out to 8 points. Just a couple of seconds ago, it was only four. Referees have left the table, now discussing things with each other right around half court. And on the broadcast, we'll likely have to wait for an announcement over the PA mic here in the arena. It looks like the referees have made a decision. They'll walk to the scorer's table. Currently 46.1 on the clock. We'll see if it changes. The announcement made was that the basket counted. Beverly shooting technical free throws at the moment. No change regarding 46.1 seconds on the clock. Beverly's first shot is a little bit short, but makes an adjustment on the second and puts it in. 7-point advantage now. 1 more free throw pending. Greenleaf the shooter. Only black jerseys on the lanes, though. This one misses. It should be a clean rebound for Colorado. It's up and it's short, but rolls in. Took a couple of bounces off the iron and drops through the cylinder. Colorado coming the opposite direction. Carter straight to the basket himself. Mirage tried to catch up, but he couldn't. 40 seconds, and they cut back in the lead, make it a 6-point game. Thomas with the ball in the backcourt. And a jump ball will be awarded to Colorado College. He was being doubled right there. Coach Dorsey signaling that he was being held. Colorado College trying to wrap around to get to the basketball. The referees will say that they did so cleanly. Carter trying to find an outlet. Inside, Sami Koglu catches underneath the basket. He fades away and banks that one in. All of a sudden, it's four again. Still 33 or so seconds remaining. Singleton will catch. Boykin pressuring, but Singleton will release up the court. Carter trying to get over and commit a foul. There were a couple of Tigers in the vicinity, right on the hip of Singleton, who had open ground in front of him. It was, in fact, Carter who committed that one. It's his third. It'll send Singleton to the free throw line where he can extend his massive day. Puts the first one up and through. Pushes it back to 5 for Centenary. He gives him 32. He's playing with 4 fouls at the moment. Second one is up and good. He's not so worried about the defense. Just trying to grow this lead. Carter brings it across, pressured by Mirage. He gives it into the corner. Rueg rises up, and he catches it. They absolutely needed that one. They got it. Back to one possession. Scott Rueg, when you need him most, makes it count. He's gone quiet, largely, in this second half. But that late three gives him 19. And keeps Colorado College alive. Still 21.2 seconds remaining in Shreveport. And fouls will give both of these teams the opportunity to walk out as champions. This game likely not going to take just the 21.2 on the clock as Coach Conroe and his squad trying everything they can to extend it. big difference in this one at the moment. That wide open layup from Greenleaf and the technical foul that ensued. His three-point play, a huge, huge factor as Centenary leads by that margin. Buzzer sounds, and Colorado is back out on the court. Neither of these teams have any timeouts remaining. Colorado College likely going to try and steal off the inbounds, but if they can't get that, I don't think they're going to waste any time trying to trap in the backcourt. Likely will foul if they can't get a takeaway immediately. Thomas threatening to trigger long, but he will not, and he'll end up getting the ball back, and he will end up being fouled. And like we said just moments ago, veteran on this squad and the guy who you want at the free throw line down the stretch. Today, 7 of 9 from the charity stripe. Two shots and Centenary's in the double bonus. First one is up on its way and it's good. Makes this a two possession game once again. There's his routine and the second one is on its way. It's up and it's also good. 5-point advantage for the Gents. Full court pressure. And the clock will start immediately as Carter brings it up the court, trying to switch it. He'll get into the corner. Another one for Ruegg. He leaves that one short. The rebound to Singleton. He'll control. And they'll have to foul with 9 seconds remaining. I believe that was the call, but based on the reaction of each of these teams, perhaps was that someone was on the sideline. No foul, because otherwise I think the Gents would be shooting the ball right here. Aggressive attempt at the steal in the corner, but a lot of contact right there. And I believe we finally will have free throws. These teams will make the journey to the other end of the court. The Gents trying to get the crowd into it. The last 7.9 seconds. Romero at the scorer's table, trying to add a little bit of a shooter bump. Are the Colorado College Tigers. But Beverly, an opportunity to really seal the game right now. Make it a 7-point advantage. The first one is up and good. He'll at least make it 6. As Crawford will come out of the game. Beverly with the ball in his hands again. Just about everyone in support of Centenary on their feet here in the Gold Dome. Carter will catch. Only 5 remaining on the clock. He'll hoist himself, and he misses off the iron. Rebound as Boykin goes to the ground. The buzzer sounds, and Centenary will celebrate. They will not be able to keep them off the court in Shreveport. The crowd will storm and celebrate with the home team. It's the way it's felt all weekend long as the Centenary Gents defend the Gold Dome, and they're your 2024 Southern Collegiate Athletic Conference champions. A wonderful second half effort. They come back trailing at the break. They win the second period 43-35, and they win this ball game 83-76. Finally, they will clear the court. With the Gents getting the chance to celebrate with their fans. Now they'll shake hands with the Colorado College Tigers, who gave it everything they had over the last 3 days. A very impressive victory over the University of Dallas. Game that they upset the Trinity University Tigers, the number one overall seed. And then they were tasked with the very difficult task of trying to beat this Centenary Gent squad in the Gold Dome, their home court. It was neck and neck most of the way, but Centenary pulling ahead proved to be just a little too much down the stretch. What a performance from Tykeem Singleton. Off the bench, he went 12 of 14, perfect 5 for 5 from three-point territory. A halftime buzzer beater heave gave them a ton of energy as they went into the locker room, and his 33 points, a huge reason why Centenary wins the conference championship, and they'll earn the auto bid into the NCAA postseason tournament. What a start to Championship Sunday. Again, a valiant effort from Colorado College. Scott Ruegg, 19 points, led the way for the Tigers. He hit a big one down the stretch. Three-pointer that gave them some life late. But it's Centenary who wins it. They'll reign as king of the SCAC. We have one more game on its way. The women's championship set to be decided next, originally scheduled for 2 o'clock. They're likely going to put about 30 minutes on the board soon. For now, as they go through the all-tournament awards, we'll take a leave on the broadcast. My name's Luke Terry. Thank you for joining us. And we hope you stick around for some more great basketball.
And the final member of the all-tournament team and the MVP from Centenary, Tykeem. Collegiate Athletic Conference Men's Basketball Champions, the Jets of Sydney.